Hello, 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 hello. And now to something different. Now I will take a closer look to into a Kern Pilat Uva. I don't know how this it actually pronounced. Uva 75 mm 1 to 2.8. AR. I don't know what the AR means. Maybe the coding. I don't know. But let's go into it. It has some problem with the fungus. I mean, real fungus. I just took a sneak peek inside just to do some research. It's actually nice build, and but let's show how it actually looks inside. You see, some, let's say, kind of fungus. Maybe other would think it's just haze. No, it isn't. But let's take a look inside. We need some tool. First, we need a 1.2 millimeter flathead screwdriver. This is very handy. And we need some tweezer, a thin one, a bigger one. I use my dentist tool a lot. Very pointy. A 1.6 millimeter screwdriver, some cotton buds, really good to have, and also we need some cleaning fluid. This is Eclipse, and this is Zippo lighter fluid, which is very good. Stinks like something. And we need some nail polish remover with acetone. We need some rubber tools, which is very handy to disassemble lenses like this in many different sizes. I also have some of those because they're very handy to put the lens on when cleaning like this. I need to measure how long is the lens actually before I disassemble it. So I put it to infinity and measure how long will this lens be at infinity. Just so I know where around I am. So something 76.4645 or so. So it's very handy to know. And of course we take the other end, the near end, just to see how it measures. And it should be something like 80, point 50 or so. Now, let's jump into this lens. I will go in from the back because some of the lens in here is not really good. Of course, there's something on the front group too. But before we do anything, set it on 1.5 millimeter. No, meter. and then take out this shape. I don't know what it is. I guess it's a shape. And we just unscrew, I mean, loosen those three screws around the focus ring. One here, there, and there is another one here. So just loosen them. That's enough. That's it. Now, be sure you have this on 1.5 meter. Then, one, we have unscrew, I mean loosen those screw. You just draw gently, very gently. See what's happened? Because inside here, maybe you can see, there are some notches all the way around. And there's only one that fits correct. I will tell you when I've taken out this. So, when I loosen this, I mean, just take it a little away. I will just set a small mark so I know where it should sit. So it's in line with the distance mark. And I go a little further, because there should be a kind of a pin in here. So, now I know where things should sit when they are proper. So I put a mark here, and I also put a mark here. See? And in here, probably we can see, there is a little pin on this, the inside of the tube, that goes into one notch that is correct for the distance. So, just to be sure, I put it back in again, correct? I just set a mark here. Some black permanent marker. Difficult to see, I know. But hopefully can be seen there. There. Now, so it's not that difficult. You just take it out and just pull it out, so you will see pop. Here we go. And where did it went? This is how it actually looks inside. So, the little pin here goes into this notch here, where I set a black mark. So it's the way it focuses. So we put that aside. Don't move it. I mean, you can. But just be sure, if one move it, just be sure to set a mark here, so you actually know where you are. And we could actually just measure this part, because that is actually the focus system, the helichoi. So we just measure how long it actually is. Okay, this is, better take it from there. This is some kind of, at 1.5 meter, this is 35.42 millimeter. So that's it. I will not do anything with this. But we could just go further into the lens. because here there is one small set screw. I need to take this tube off to go further into the back lens group. So just unscrew it just a little, because it's not very good made. The metal is very thin. So that's it. A turn, half a quarter, three quarter a turn, that's enough. Now this goes counterclockwise, this one, and just unscrew it. Sit tight. Maybe this one needs a little more. Yeah, just a little. Okay, I take it out. And then we can get a good grip on the front, not on the aperture ring, but on the front here. And then get a good grip. Then we need to unscrew it. And it goes. We begin here, close to the number or to the distance mark. And then we go all the way at the, we just put a mark here. So it's in line with the distance mark. So just put a mark here somewhere, so you know where you end up. So we go 1, 2, 3 and something, 3/4. My distance mark is here and my set screw hole is there. And where this is where it comes off. I can just pull off my focus ring. Remember the stop. This is a screw on side here, and it goes through this all the way around to the infinity. So this is where it is. So just take it off so it's not in way. Now we better can see what's actually going on with this very fungus. Better take a look. Not really good, but hopefully it can get better with some cleaning fluidium. So to get this ring off here and get this lens, the back lens out, we can do two things. I can use my lens, spanner, walking stick or so, whatever it is, compass, and adjust it to fit proper in here, and just unscrew it. Or I can do another more safer way to unscrew it. I can use a rubber stopper, which you can buy in those shops who are selling things for home brewing beer. And it actually 31 millimeter. No, not for this one. Sorry. We use the black one here, which will come in very handy. Not the big, this, but number 3 size. And it just push in and then press and unscrew. Then the ring will come off gently. So, here we are. And then here is just the lens. Well, to be sure it's safe to work with and clean, I will just use my rubber tool. And do it the opposite. So I do so, and then put this on here, like this, and turn it over. And then my lens should actually just come off if I gently. Here we are. This is the aperture, nice and fine. Let's see if there is anything there. Oh yeah, there's some haze in the one of the. This, I think it's the middle group or so. See. So we'll take a closer look later. But for now, just close the aperture so not so much dust come in. And then need some gloves. At least one. So, now it's better. Now we need some PackPat non-abrasive wipes. This is very good to clean lenses. I mean, lens elements. So I just take one out. And do some try just to see how it actually looks. You see, the lens, how it should face, it's the curve is much more on this side, and this is more, what do you say, flat. I mean, to me, it looks more than the curve is. Let's see. Yeah. The curve is more here. And this side is more flat, just to be sure. So, well, we have some issue with that lens. But let's see if it works. So, I'll just try the Eclipse. So I put my my wipe on here and just put a few drops of Fluidium. So it's wet. And then try some gently. I'm not sure this will work, but well, at least this is more clear. But I'm not really sure it will help so much. Take the other side. Actually, I can feel those grooves, like the fungus has made in the lens surface. So I'm not sure this will work proper. Okay, we'll give it another go with some lighter fluid, just to see if ink it can do any difference. Well, not really. So I think I'll just put this bag in again and let it stay there. So just put my lens over. This. And turn it over. The focus ring goes on here at 1.5 meter, and then the focus thingy, put it back in, get the groove, here it is, and just unscrew it back in again. And it will end up over here, close to the number and my mark, which I set before. And then the screw. So, there it is. And then, oh, that was stupid. See what I miss? Yes, of course. I miss the retaining ring. So, give it another go. And because I put those marks on, I can always get things back in again without any problems. Because I know where it is. I know how long things are, and I know exactly where it sit before I took it out. Therefore, marks are very important, because there is no service manual. So, put the focus ring on, and the tube here. And it should say something click. Here we are. There's something wrong here. Looks there's some kind of dirt or whatever it is. Just to be sure it's not something that shouldn't be there. So it's just a fragment of kind of aluminium, and we put it back in again. So the focus ring there, the tube here, and it goes here, click, and then we are back on track. Very thin metal. So and then we put this on. .5 millimeter. And I have my mark here, which should go there. And the small pin that we need to sit correct on one groove. Where I set a mark here. Not the wrong, but the correct one, which is there. And then it should just fit on here. Then the small screws and gently screw them in. No need for too much pressure. So. And just to be sure everything is in proper order, I just do a gently measure. We begin with this, I mean, and we ended up with this. So now we take the front lens groups, which also there are some haze. I would like to see if I can take it away. I need my rubber stopper. It's for the front. I could use my walking stick here, or compass, and unscrew it. Yep. Just loosen it, and then let the rubber stopper or this one do the rest. It's much easier. The retaining ring. Oh, just put this in so it's, we know where it is. Wow, one lens pop out. But it's not a problem. Don't do two things at a time. I will just, let's see. We do this. And let it stay on this side here. This is the front. This is the back into the lens body. So, but this one actually looks, well, should say okay or something. There's something on the front here, but I will just take it away after. But it actually looks fine. So we put this aside and take a closer look into here. Because this lens in here have a lot of haze. It should be fine if I could remove that. So I will give it a go. My my lens spinner, because it can sit pretty tight. So, and then, yes, it goes, and then I will just unscrew it. So, we're almost there. And then I can just do the rest with my rubber tool here. Use my tweezer to take out the retaining ring. And take out the lens. I will just do it with this one. Put it in. Turn it over and see if it can. No. Okay. What's going on here? It should just pop off, but doesn't. Maybe if we just press a little. No. That was funny. Well, take a break. Okay, yeah. You see, the haze is actually on the front of this lens group. I cannot get it out, so but doesn't really matter because I can see where the haze is on the front here. So let's do some cleaning with some lens tissue and some cleaning fluid. I'll just try the Eclipse first, just to see how good it is. And how does it look? Still haze. Good. Well, then we give it a go with the lighter fluid and see if it can work. Still, a lot of haze. That was weird. Yeah. Well. There's nothing I can do about it. So I'll just put it back in again. Well, if you have haze in your lens here, like this, it could be the way of getting it cleaned. But since there's too much, So here we are, and then tighten it. There. And the front lens. Put it on. And the retaining ring. You see, it's not every time one can be lucky and clean those old lenses. But, this lens wasn't really good. So, but at least I give it a go, but yeah, that was it. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.